Hello. 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 Hello.
Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello. Good to see you. So we're here because the Supreme Court in Poland is in danger. On 3rd of July, a new law is coming into force that will make the Supreme Court a politicized one. And right now, the only option for Poland to save the rule of law is for the European Commission to file the law on the Supreme Court to the European Court of Justice. And we're really hoping that the EPP, also with Jean-Claude Juncker, could push this forward. Because for Poland, this is really the only chance and the last chance having rule of law and having courts that are independent from the judiciary as well. So that's why we're here, and we wanted to hand you a petition. It has been signed by more than 100 NGOs, 120 NGOs. Here in Poland. Also, there is a separate petition from Polish artists and influencers, which has been signed by people like, you know, Agnieszka Holland or Pawlikowski, who has just been awarded.
The most famous Polish movie directors, writers, poets, intellectuals, professors, and so on. So the most prominent people from Poland are crying in desperation for your support. Because actually we don't have any constitutional court power here. And the only constitutional court available for us is in Europe, and it's an European Union Court of Justice. So please, please help us. We know Mr. Juncker's position, realistic one. But this is not only the matter of our principles of democracy. We do believe that as the rule of law is destroyed in here in Poland, whose legal system is fully integrated into European legal system. This also threatens the integrity, the legal integrity of the entire European Union. So please, this is our common matter. Support us, please.
There's also one more letter signed by more than 60,000 Polish citizens.
Well, and there's been some support also from foreign organizations, so also foreign NGOs is from Hungary, France, even Germany have supported our case, because as Paweł said, this is not only a Polish case, this is a test for the European democracy, and it's going to be very important for the rule of law in the whole Europe as well.
And it's not lost, we can still win it.
And if I can add, Manfred, this is intergenerational. Pavel was involved in Solidarity Movement in 1980, one of the key persons at that time in Wrocław. And this is young generation also, so I think it's very, very important for all.
Thank you so much. You know that the fundamental question for the today's European Union is the rule of law. That is a fundamental question. Europe was the first time after the Second World War, first in the West, and then when we had the unification after 1990, the reunification of Europe. Europe was the first time not unified with war, it was not unified by economy, it was unified by the rule of law, by a treaty, by judges. That is the fundament of today's Europe. And that's why it is so important to keep it as a fundament. The second point is we can do some steps from European, more administrative point in a way, that Europe is acting, and you know that Commission was decisive in a way because they presented Article 7 procedure already. Parliament was, I think, clear in all these points. And that's why there was a clear, but what we need is, as European decision makers, as politicians from Europe, we need a civil society who is really driving them, because the future of a country cannot be driven by an outside power, it must be driven by domestic issues. That's why the civil society is so important, and I want to be frank, I really admire you that you managed to have so many people behind you with the petitions, but also with the demonstrations directly when the decision was taken.
So many people were there, of people on the streets supporting.
That was really great to see. But both elements are important.